今日ね、僕も会うの3回目なんですよ。このバンドに会うの。メガデス来てもらいました。デブ・ムステインさんとアルピトレリさんです。Welcome to Japan once again.
Thank you.
And nice to see you for the first time.
Thank you for having me.
And so how was the show last night?
It was good. You know, it's great to be able to come back and play in Japan. Although we would like to play the Tokyo Dome. You know, there comes a time where you have to go into different marketplaces and play places that the scene isn't this big. And last time we played in Yokohama, we played at a really small club. Mm-hmm. And this was a step up for us, so we're building.
Okay, then what can the kids expect for the show tonight?
Well, we're playing music off of the new record, Risk, and we're doing a real healthy offering with music from all the records of our whole career, except the very first one. We don't play anything off that first one because you really can't find that record anywhere. So I feel we're kind of teasing the audience, playing stuff that they won't be able to find.
Mm-hmm. And I've seen you play in Beautiful Monsters Tour at Mount Fuji last time you came here. Mm-hmm. And is the show going to be more different than the last one also?
The last one that you saw was really short.
It was
a festival concert, and you know, when you play in a situation like that, you've got a headliner playing over you and the bill, you need to play a less time, and you also don't have the same kind of liberties that you want to have, stage space, use of the PA, stuff like that. And being our show tonight, we're going to do whatever we want. If I want to roll around on the floor, I can. Mm-hmm. You know, if we want to play for 2 hours, we can.
Mm-hmm. Good. I'd really like to see the show tonight. But, you know, Al, you're really new to the band. And so wasn't it really hard for you to just fit in the band and be able to play all the songs, all the set list?
This was by far the most challenging music I've ever had to play. I've been a fan of the bands for many, many years, but to actually play the songs on stage, you know, it was definitely probably the most difficult thing I've done musically in a long time. Mm-hmm.
So, how long did it take for you to play as a Megadeth on stage?
Well, I thought I had the songs learned after a couple of days until, I sat down with David and he showed me exactly how terribly I had learned the songs. So, to be honest with you, to this day I'm still listening to the CDs and always, you know, learning a part that I may have missed and always fine-tuning the material. It's so involved that it would be very arrogant for me to say that I have it together by now. They will certainly tell you that I don't. I'll just allude to that fact. But it's challenging, it's terrific, and it's forcing me to do things physically on the guitar that I'm not used to doing, so it's broadening me as a musician.
And you've been playing with Alice Cooper and many other artists. Mm-hmm. And how is it like to... What is it for you to be in Megadeth?
It's a thrill. I mean, again, as a fan, to be able to be on the stage and playing Megadeth songs with Megadeth is great. I'm very excited. You know, it's still very new for me, so I'm starting to learn, you know, how to be the guitar player in Megadeth. You know, I feel like a little kid again. You know, my first guitar, my first band. I mean, you know, to be in a band, an internationally multi-platinum touring band, to be asked to be part of that is just wonderful. It's a wonderful opportunity.
You're in the band as a permanent member, right?
Well, here's what we look for in a band member. We look for someone who can play really well, mm-hmm. someone who's got the right image for the band, someone that has a really good personality. Mm-hmm. And Al definitely has these three things that we're looking for. However, we haven't made up our mind yet what we're going to do, because it's a real critical decision for us to make. Mark Friedman has left some very big shoes to fill. He's been with us for 10 years. And we don't want to make a decision and end up regretting it. And, you know, Al would really like it to be his position, and we really feel that Al has the ability to do it. He also has the the qualities we're looking for. We just need to make absolutely sure that we're not overlooking someone else, and that we're not making any mistakes right now. As it is, the fans have come up to Al, and Al has done such a tremendous job with doing the parts. They come up and say, "Marty, please sign this." They think he's Marty, so.
Look straight ahead.
Yes, I mean, it's cool. No one really, they haven't noticed, they don't care. You know, they just love Megadeth music. They see, they think he's Marty because he's kicking ass out there. And at this point right now, we're absolutely fine with how things are going. And when we get home, we're going to start our new record. And we'll probably make a decision sometime in the next couple months. Mm-hmm.
And when you're writing songs and recording for a new album, do you think the songs will change when Marty's replaced to Al?
Do I think that the songs are going to change with a new guitar player in there? Mm-hmm. To a degree. Marty didn't really have a lot of songwriting involvement with Megadeth. He did have a lot of really beautiful suggestions and parts that he did help us with. Mm-hmm. But with Al being in the rehearsals we did the last couple of weeks while we were at home, the same things that Marty contributed with, basically telling me music theory and the laws of certain notes being in the right places if it works in a chord, Al knows the same thing. So it wasn't really like we'd lost anything. Mm-hmm. The decision right now comes down basically to if the personalities are going to click. You know, Megadeth is such a state-of-the-art class organization, and just the way that we walk and talk and how we behave and what we do with the fans and how we're perceived by the public. You know, we are the royal family of heavy metal when it comes down to who's left. Most of the people that are in hard rock and heavy metal bands have, relatively little class. And I don't say that to say anything mean about them. They're great musicians, but that's what sets us apart from a lot of these other bands. And there's a lot of stuff that when we have someone come into the band, we need to show them how we do things. And it's just the way that we handle ourselves, it's the way that we handle the fans, it's the way that we do all of the photographs and interviews and stuff like that. It's a serious learning curve, and right now it's been real easy with Al around because he's a quick learner, he watches what's going on, and he stays under radar, if you know what I mean. Mm-hmm. We had another person who auditioned for us, and that was a great guitar player. I heard his CD, and I thought, this guy's really, really good. And he came down, and he was actually recommended by Marty Friedman to take his place. And the guy came down, and even Marty said, this guy ain't the right guy. Because his look was wrong, his personality was absolutely 100% opposite of what we were looking for. And the only thing he had going for him was playing ability, and when we sat down to play, he didn't know one fucking song.
That's hard. Let me just interrupt 1 minute. There's a reason why bands are perceived the way they are. There's a reason why a band like this is where they are for so long. And as an outsider, you think, well, it's because of good music and this. Being inside of it, you see the real work of the blind. The longevity takes is there.
Why is that? What is that?
Just everything that Dave just explained. There's a reason why some people perceive the stars and some people aren't. Yeah, so it's been, not only musically, but across the board, quite a hard experience.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned auditioning, but did you audition many people until Al came on?
The only reason that I was even here right now, as opposed to us having an open cattle call audition, was that Marty had told us on the tour, in the middle of the tour, that he was planning on leaving and that he would stay through the Japanese dates, but not through South America. And I thought, I'm sorry, but we're not going to allow that for you to get a free trip to Japan when you're going to quit anyways. And we decided, we've got a choice. Either we find someone now or we don't go to Japan, and I was not going to cancel Japan. So we started discussing who we felt was the right people, and Marty was absolutely willing to come over here, but we weren't willing to do that because, you know, everyone knows how much Marty loves Japan, and I know how much he loves Japan, and how much Japan loves Marty. We just didn't want to prolong the agony of having a member that we knew was leaving. We wanted to just get it over with and just, you know, start over again. And right now we're in kind of a transition. Marty had a physical problem when he went home and got really sick. And he told David Ellison, he said, "You better get someone right now because I'm having heart attack-like symptoms." And David Ellison told me, and I talked to Jimmy DeGrasso, and Jimmy said, "Let's get Al." And Al came out, and I think the first day that he showed up was January 7th, and January 17th, I think, was his first concert. And I don't know anybody who would be able to learn all those songs, all those solos, and all those background vocal bits in 10 days. So
that is incredible.
Wow. So if he doesn't get the job, we're going to hire him to teach the new guy the voice.
Okay, that's the way to do it, is it? Okay, then I'm really looking forward to the show tonight, so good luck for the show.
Thank you very much.
Thanks so much.
Thanks for being on the show.
Oh, thanks for having us.
Cheers. Megadeth.
From sight, I peg to the shadows. I can't sleep.